Okay, so basically we discussed that if x is equal to a power m, then log x base a is equal to m. That's the definition. The conditions are x should be positive, a should be positive, and a should not be 1. Okay. And based on this, we gave some numbers to find the log of things. And we discussed basically log m base a plus log n base a is equal to log mn base a. Similarly, log m base a minus log n base a is log m by n base a. And then log m power n base a is n times log n base a. I think these are the three formulas that we have seen. And in general, log 1 with any base is 0. And log a base a is 1. Okay. These are the main things that we discussed yesterday. Oh, I forgot I have to clarify the doubts, right? Okay, let me finish and then we'll discuss the doubts at the end. Okay, so some more formulas we want to discuss. Log m base a power n is 1 by n times log m base a. Yesterday we seen when the power is here, it will come out in the numerator. But when the power is here, it will come out in the denominator. Okay, so how to prove this? You can take this as x or whatever it is, anything is fine. Let log m base a is equal to x, m is equal to a power x. At a power x, I can write it as a power 1 by n into nx. I multiplied with n and divided with n in the power. And that I can write a power 1 by n whole power nx. So when I write m as a power of a power 1 by n, that power is nx. So I can write log m base a power 1 by n is equal to nx. But what is x we started with? Log m base a. That's it. Replace x with the log m base a. Did I write something wrong here? No, sorry. N here is better. N here into x by n. Okay. This also right. So we wanted formula for n here. This will be x by n, which is 1 by n times log n base. Okay. So yesterday we seen when the power is here, we got n in the numerator. But when the base has a power, it came out in the denominator. All right. Okay, if somebody has to copy, especially those are learning for the first time, they can copy. Through the questions, we'll see how to use all the formulas. Okay, so this present formula and previous formula, once again, I'm writing. I want to combine them and write one more formula. If you have log m power n base a, it is n times log m base a. And if you have log m base a power n, it is 1 by n times log m base a. Okay, so when the power is here, you can see it came out in the numerator when the power is here. So if you want to combine both of them, let us say I have log a power p base b power q. This power will come out in the numerator. This power will come out in the denominator. It will come p by q log a base. The power of a we have to be put in the numerator. The power of b has to be put in the denominator. So this is combination of these two formulas. Okay, next formula. Log m base b into log b base a is equal to log m base a. You can see here this one and this one are same. In the future, we can just cancel. Okay, it's not a proper way to write cancel, but you can imagine as if you are canceling these two, you got log m base. But how will you prove it? Let log m base b equal to x. Let us take this as x, and log b base a is equal to some point. You can send this b here and this a here. I will get m is equal to b power x, and b is equal to a power y. And this b equal to a power y, I am going to substitute here, which I will get a power y whole power x, which is a power x y. So when you express m as a power of a, that power is x y. So I can write log m base a is equal to x y. What is x and y? These two only. So we prove x is log m base b, y is log b base a. So basically, when two things are same, because one here and one here, you can cancel, and whatever is here will come there. Whatever here will come in the base. Okay, those are learning for the first time. I hope you are able to follow.
Yes, sir.
Okay. You'll get a better clarity when we use it in the questions. Okay. I think some of them may not have hard copies of the material. I'll send the PDF yesterday. I forgot to send today. I'll send this rather than PDF. Okay, that's it. We are almost done with the formulas. Okay, just now whatever we've done, we can rearrange this. Log m base b into log b base a is equal to log m base a. That's what we've done just now. Okay. So I'm going to, you can bring it this one down. Log m base b is equal to log m base a by log b base a. This formula we are going to use quite often. This is a previous formula, we proved it. I just brought this one down. Basically, what this formula says, log m base b, you can write it as log m by log b. Log of this and log of this with any base a. See, here there is no a at all. So that means a can be anything. Somebody can take base 2, base 3, base 5, base 10, base 100, anything you can take. Log m base b. Usually when nothing is mentioned, we'll take base e, and e is 1 plus 1 by 1 factorial, 1 by 2 factorial, 1 by 3 factorial, 1 by 4 factorial, so on. Where a 2 factorial means product of first two natural numbers, 3 factorial means product of first three natural numbers, 4 factorial means product of first four natural numbers, so on. Okay, so that whole number is called e. Generally when nothing is mentioned, we take base e. In sometimes in chemistry, they may tell you to take base 10. But in this formula, it is not about base e or base 10. So why I did not write base is base can be anything. This a can be anything. Of course, it should be positive and it should not be 1. Okay, this is just a rearrangement of the previous formula. ओके ए पावर सॉरी ए पावर लॉग एम बेस ए इज इक्वल टू एम. ओके बेसिकली व्हेन दिस ए एंड दिस ए आर सेम यू विल बी लेफ्ट विद दिस सेम. ओके हाउ टू प्रूव दिस. दिस प्रूफ इज सो सिंपल दैट आई कैन एक्चुअली फिल दिस एज द फर्स्ट फॉर्मुला आफ्टर द डिफाइनिंग द लॉगरिथम. व्हाई फॉर द डेफिनेशन ऑफ लॉगरिथम x equal to a power m implies log x base a is equal to m, right? Or whatever it is, I can write even x also. We are not able to so write x. Okay. Now, in the place of this m, put this log x base a back here. That's if you got this. A power what is m? Log x base a. That's all. Okay. So the proof of it is very simple. In the definition, wherever m is there, substitute this back. Okay. So basically, when this and this are same, whatever is here, you can write that. That's the point. There's one more formula. It is not mentioned in this. I did not see carefully, but a power log b base c. You can bring this b here and this a here without changing the position of this, which is b power log a base. How to prove this? Start with LHS. A power log b base c. I'm going to write this a as b power log a base b. Power log b base. Okay, how A became this? Based on this formula. If this and this are same, only this will come. So A can be written as B power log A base. This A can be written like this based on this formula. Now A power M whole power N is A power M and I can multiply. I'll get B power log A base B into log B base C. This B and this B are same. That is also one of the formula that you can. And these two are same, forget about them, we'll get log a base c. So we'll get b power log a base c, which is RHS. Okay. Anybody any doubt about either proof of this or proof of this?
Sir, second proof, can you explain on that?
Okay. First proof has a formula I'm using in the second proof. In the place of a, I wrote b power log a base b. Because according to this formula, what is, if these two are same, this will come. So because this is b and this is b, they're same. If you remove it, you'll get a. It is exactly this. Now it is b power m whole power n. I can multiply the powers m into n. Okay, another formula that we have is if this and this are same, we can cancel, we'll get log a base b. That is RHS. In total, final out. In total, how to remember this formula? You can bring B here, A here. You can interchange these two without changing the position of this. Anybody else? Those are learning logarithms for first time. You have any doubt what I discussed so far? I hope exercise 2, all of you submitted homework yesterday afternoon.
Yes, sir.
Yes,
yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
By chance, if somebody not submitted, please submit today. You have one more week to go before your holidays. Some people must be counting on that.
How many days are they going to give holidays, sir?
Already mentioned, right?
Yes, sir. 22 to 28.
Yeah. It is there in the magazine. If you notice carefully, it is there. They might have mentioned in the group also. I don't know. But but in the magazine.
It's there in the magazine.
Yeah, right on the front page. Left side.
When to when, sir?
22nd to 28th. Both ways included. Closed interval 22 to 28.
Yes, sir.
Normally, they will tell these holidays well before, so that if people have to go to different places, they have to do reservations and all that. No, nobody has to do any reservations. Okay. So, something about graph and inequalities I want to mention once again, but let us do a few questions. Let the people get some clarity on the logarithms and then we'll do it. So, as usual, in the objectives, I'll discuss odd numbers and even numbers. You can do homework. Okay. There are not many, few questions only. Yesterday, I sent a preparatory course material that we had done earlier with the solutions also, I think. So those are learning for the first time or somebody forgot. You want to go through the questions, you can go through there. Okay, objective exercise. I'm not screen sharing the questions. Very first one, they're asking log 7 base 2, whether it is a rational number or irrational number. Okay. Basically, if you want to prove something is irrational, don't have any specific method. The usual method that we do is we assume it is rational and prove that it is not possible. By negative method only we prove. Okay. So let log 7 base 2 is a rational number. Anybody want to tell me, I may not be able to find this value exactly, but its value is between two natural numbers. What are they?
So 2 and 3.
2 and 3, yes. Because 7 is between 4 and 8, and log 4 base 2 is 2, and log 8 base 2 is 3. So log 7 base 2 is some number between 2 and 3. But whether it is a, when you really find a value, is it a terminating decimal? Or non-terminating, repeating, or non-terminating, non-repeating. But instead of that, we'll assume this is a rational number. What is a rational number? Any rational number will be in the form of P by Q, where P, comma, Q are integers. And HCF of P, comma, Q is equal to 1 and Q not equal to 0. That's the definition of a rational number. These are integers. They don't have any common factor other than 1. Denominator should not be 0. According to the definition of log, 7 should be 2 power p by q. When I do power q on both sides, I'll get 7 power q is equal to 2 power p. I don't think I can find integers such as that these two are equal. Not possible, because 2 power any natural number if you take. Okay, it is an even number. And this is an odd number. Even number and odd number cannot be equal. All right. So 7 power q cannot be equal to 2 power q. So our assumption that is a rational number is wrong. So log 7 base 2 is not a rational number. It is obviously a real number. There is some number between 2 and 3 which can give that, but it is not rational. It has to be irrational. So whenever they want us to prove something is irrational, we generally prove like this only. Those who have the book, they can try third question. I hope nobody has doubt about this first question, right? Okay, one more formula I might have not told explicitly is that 1 by log A base B can be written as, or log A base B can be written as 1 by log B base A. Okay, you can understand in different ways. Log A base B means log A by log B with any base. This is log B by log A, so obviously reciprocal. Or when you bring these two together, product log A base B into log B base C. Because these two are same, we'll get log A base A, and log A base A is 1. Because this product is 1, for this you can bring it down. We'll get. So whenever you take a log, you want to take reciprocal, you have to just interchange these two. That's it. Okay, so third question. The question is 3, 4, 5. Okay. 1 by log x base 3 plus 1 by log x base 4 plus 1 by log x base 5. According to this formula, you can reverse this. I'm going to get log 3 base x, log 4 base x, and log 5 base x. And we have formula when bases are same, log m plus log n is log m into n, if you have three things also. So it is log of 3 into 4 into 5 base x. Only when bases are same, log m base a plus log n base a, you can write log m into n. If you have plus log 3 base a, you can write m into n into p, which is log 60 base x. Okay. Directly is not there, so it's reciprocal is there, where log x base 60. Because you have to interchange these two when I want to bring it down. Okay, anybody doubt about third question? Okay, fifth question, I think should have been not given here, but it's okay. I have to tell you one formula for, one more formula for this question. It's generally we study later. Okay. So before doing fifth question, you should know that log 2 is equal to 1 minus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 3 minus 1 by 4 plus 1 by 5 minus 1 by 6 plus 1 by 3. Right? All right. Okay. How this came right now, don't worry. Okay. Later on, we'll discuss in detail. Actually, this series doesn't end. Many numbers can be written as an infinite series. In fact, for every real number can be written as an infinite series. That is the actual definition of a real number as such. There is a sequence and the limit of that is a real number. We are not studying about all that now. Okay, right now how it came, don't worry, just take it. Okay, this is a log 2 or equal to this. All right. For doing fifth question, we may need this. The question is log 2 base 4 minus log 2 base 8 plus log 2 base 16 minus log 2 base 32. So, this 4, yes, sir. Yes, Saket, what do you want?
Sir, log 2 base can be anything, sir.
No, no, it is base E here. When nothing is mentioned, it is base.
Okay. Okay.
What is E? Already I told you, but you know, just take it. Okay, so this 2, I'm going to write 2 square. This 8, I'm going to write 2 cube. This 16, I'm going to write 2 power 4. This 32, I'm going to write 2 power 4. We have a formula that we have any power, we'll take it out in the numerator. If we have any power, we'll take it out in the denominator. So this is going to be 1 by 2 times log 2 base 2, 1 by 3 times log 2 base 2, 1 by 4 times log 2 base 2, 1 by 5 times log 2 base 2. Okay. When you have a power here, we'll take it out in the numerator. When you have a power here, we'll take it out in the denominator based on that formula. But log 2 base 2 is 1 everywhere. Forget about that. Okay, so this is 1 by 2 minus 1 by 3 plus 1 by 4 minus 1 by 5. So if I want to use this, I need a minus. Okay. So I'm going to take minus common and write minus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 3 minus 1 by 4 plus 1 by 5. So this is almost same as log 2. Okay. But one is missing. So I can add one separate. 1 minus 1 by 2. And that first of all minus 1 plus 1. Minus 1 by 2, plus 1 by 3, minus 1 by 4, plus 1 by 5. So minus of minus 1 plus this whole thing is log 2. So finally it is 1 minus log 2. Okay. So for doing this question, first of all, you should convert all the denominator, all the bases as a power of 2. Take out the powers by the one formula that we have. Log 2 base 2 is 1. And for that, you have to know what is log 2. And you don't mention, I said it is base C usually.
Sir?
Yes, please.
Sir, why only we take like a base of anything as E, sir? Why only E?
E has some significance. We'll discuss about E. Okay.
Sir, if anything not mentioned, we should take 10, sir.
No, no, no. That is maybe in school level, they might have taught like that. But in JE advanced and JE mains, when nothing is mentioned, it is base E by default. Okay. Only
okay,
in chemistry, you will take base 10. Okay. For calculation purpose. And next, when you take very old books, not the recent books, very old mathematics books, especially some, you know, some Russian books and other things, which earlier people used to follow. Log means base 10 and ln. Sometimes you can write log as ln also. Ln means base E. They used to write like that. Okay. But in JE advanced and mains now, log or ln, both are base E only unless otherwise mentioned. Okay. What is E? We'll discuss. Yes, please.
Sir, like, can you tell it simply, sir? What is the significance?
What is?
What is the significance of E?
Yeah, well, actually, to know, you have to know somewhere when limit chapter is over on the other track, then we'll come back and discuss something about you. Okay.
Okay, sir.
E is a number that actually we cannot avoid it. Okay, it will keep coming in. But you have to know some details about it. That means you have to have some more maths you have to learn, then we can discuss. Nice.
Sir, what is IN, sir, here?
IN, where is IN? Oh, that is LN only, they printed as like that. Okay, LN, log, both are same. Okay.
Oh.
Sir, once explain. Okay, I got it, sir.
Got it. Anybody by so far, whatever I discussed, if any doubt, please feel free to ask. I'm ready to explain anything.
Sir, once again, can you tell how log 2 base is 1 minus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 3 minus 1 by 4, that one?
That I did not explain. I just said, just take it.
Oh, okay, sir.
I did not prove it for anybody here. I just told, just accept it. Okay.
Yes, sir. Sir, if any question it comes, log 3 base you have to then...
No, no, no. Log 3 and all doesn't have this kind of formula. Only for log 2 base. Okay?
Oh, okay.
Log 3 base is also there. Okay? But we don't use like a general result. But this is quite used. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Sir, what is the value of E, sir?
E is f. This is an irrational number. We cannot write it because it is non-terminating, non-repeating decimal. But it is around 2.71 odd. Okay. In calculator, you type, just type E, it will come. Directly E will be there.
Yes, sir. It's, but like, only that is not this. Like, E is there, sir, but it is the electrical charge of electrons, sir.
Oh, that E. Okay. I'm sure it will be there. No, where log is there, below that you see E will be there. LOG log, in that small corner, you will find E.
Sir, 2.71828182858, sir.
Yeah, that is as far as your display can allow. But it is a non-terminating, non-repeating decimal.
Yes.
All right. This is the fifth question done. So, seventh question. Seventh question is log x square minus 3x plus 6 base 10 is equal to 1. I'm sure this is just based on the original definition, just sent on that side. X square minus 3x plus 6 is 10 power 1. Which is x square minus 3x minus 4 equal to 0. We will get x minus 4 into x plus 1 equal to 0. So x is equal to 4 or minus 1. Both are okay. You substitute any one of them. Just look on 10 and log 10 base 10 is 1.
Sir, they gave wrong answer, sir, but in opportunity.
No, it should be Delhi. If they're not given, just P is wrong. They gave A, so P should be wrong. Okay. Okay, this is very simple. Just log x base a means x is equal to a power m. This is a simple quadratic. Actually, this can be the first question. Okay, ninth one, the number of pairs x comma y satisfying this. Okay, two equations and two unknowns to solve that. But I think first equation gives us that x and y are equal. Let us go to prove. they gave log x base y plus log y base x equal to log x base y. Log y base x can be written as 1 by log x base y. Whenever you write reciprocal, you can interchange these two. And I multiply now, I'll get log x base y whole square plus 1 is equal to 2 times log x base y. And I bring one side, you'll get a perfect square, log x base y minus 1 whole square equal to 0. Okay. So from that, I can say log x base y minus 1 should be 0. Log x base y equal to 1. X is equal to y power 1, which is 1. Basically, the first equation tells x and y are equal. X is equal to y power 1. The second equation is x square equal to 20 plus y, but x and y are equal. So I can write y as x. That is x square minus x minus 20 equal to 0. I will get x minus 5 into x plus 4 equal to 0. So I'll get x is equal to 5 and y or x equal to minus 4. And x equal to 5, y is also 5, and x is minus 4, y equal to minus 4. But you cannot take this minus 4, you can only take this. Why? Log x base y is defined only when x and y are positive and y not equal to 1. How can x or y be negative? So it can't be. So even though we are getting a negative number is also answer, we have to reject it.
Sir, yes, log please. X base y whole square is equal to 0, sir.
No. I brought this one, this side. A square minus 2a plus 1 is a perfect square, no?
Oh, okay, sir.
Okay. First this part, next this part, next this. This I took as 1 by interchange these two. Multiplied with that everywhere. Brought this one here, it became a perfect square. Something square is 0 means it itself should be 0. Finally, I got x equal to y. In that equation where y is there, I wrote x. Even though I got two values, I should not take the second one because in the question, indirectly, it is x and y should be positive.
Sir?
Yes, please.
Sir, but if we substitute for x and y as minus 4, we will get the answer as minus 1, sir.
When you put x and y as minus 4, where?
Sir, for a log x to the base y, so it becomes log minus 4 to the base minus 4, it is 1, sir.
This is 1, what about this one?
Sir, that also is 1, no, sir.
And what is 1 plus 1?
2.
But log minus 4 base minus 4 is not 1. Log minus 4 base minus 4 is a wrong question. Because right in the definition we said, x should be positive, y should be positive. Okay, because of yes. They asked what? 1 minute, let me see. The number of pairs. So only one pair. 5, 5. X is 5, y is 5.
Sir, one, can you draw the graph for it?
Graph of what?
The intersection of them.
Okay, you want me to draw y equal to x square minus 20 graph and y equal to x graph. You want me to draw that? Okay. But it is not y equal to x full line. It is only a ray. Why? It is indirectly means x should be greater than 0, y should be greater than 0. So it is not full graph, only the first quadrant ray. If you draw the graph, as you can see, x square minus 20 is like this. Y equal to x is like this. There are two points of intersection. To be precise, this is 5, this is minus 4. But y equal to x is only this ray, not the down part. You should not take it. Because of that, you should reject. Yeah, if it is one number of solutions, somebody can draw the graph of the two curves and then you can also do it. But you have to see the conditions under which question is defined. Okay, those are learning for the first time. Whether you can do questions on your own or not, you will be able to do it. When I discuss more questions, but I hope you are understanding what I am discussing. Those are learning for first time, I strongly recommend you do preparatory course once, because there are small, small questions on basic formulas. So that you look more thorough with the formulas. Okay. After this class, I'll upload the material. I already sent with solutions, but once again, I'll find the relevant things that I forwarded earlier in the preparatory course. Okay. I'm not missing anything. I'm covering only just more variety of questions, more simple questions. I'm not telling now. Anybody else have any doubt regarding 9? Okay. 11. Log 3 base 2 is A. Log 5 base 3 is B. And log 2 base 7 is C. They want us to write a log 63 base 140 in terms of ABC. Okay. What is a log 63 base 140 in terms of ABC? Okay. I want to write everything as base 2. Already this is fine for me. I want log 5 also in terms of base 2, log 7 also in terms of base 2. So I'll write log 3 base 2 as A. And I multiply these two, I'll get log 5 base 2 as AB. Because this is a 3, this is 3, they are same. We have a formula that to log, when you multiply two logs, when this and this are same, you can cancel, you'll get log 5 base 2 as AB. This one, when I take reciprocal, log 7 base 2 is 1 by 6. Log 7 base 2 is reciprocal of log 2 base 7. Okay, now I got everything in terms of base 2. Now what to do? Log 63 base 140, I will write log 63 base 2, log 140 base 2. I know log A base B, I can write log A by log B with any base. I can write base 2 here, base 5, base 7. But I chose base 2 because I got everything in terms of base 2. That's all. Log A base B is log A by log B with any base. Now 63 is 7 into 9, 7 into 3 square. And 140, if I convert into prime factors, it is 2 into 4 into 35. So 2 square into 5 into 7. Log A into B, I can add log A plus log B. Log AB, say I can add log A plus log B plus log C. So this is going to be log 7 base 2 plus log 3 square base 2. This one, log 2 square base 2, log 5 base 2, log 7 base 2. Okay, so log, we're using many formulas here. Here we used one formula for multiplying these two. So take reciprocal, one formula. Log A base B is log A by log B. That itself is one formula. And log A into B is log A plus log B. And when the power is here, you can take it out. So it will become log 7 base 2 plus 2 times log 3 base 2. When you have power, you can take it out. This is going to be 2 times log 2 base 2, log 5 base 2, log 7 base 2. Log 7 base 2 is 1 by C. Log 3 base 2 2 times is 2A. Log 2 base 2 is 1. Log 5 base 2 is AB. And log 7 base 2 is 1 by C. Multiply c everywhere, we'll get 1 plus 2ac by 2c plus abc plus 1. Then multiply c here, c here. Okay. I think most of the formulas in logarithms were used here. Okay. Log a into b is used. Log a power m is m log a is used. Log a base b is log a by log b. Anybody has any doubt about 11th question, any part of it, please ask. Okay, everybody clear about 11th one?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So 13 is very easy. Just the next one, 13. Okay, 13 is log x square minus 3x minus 5 base 3 equal to log 7 minus 2x base 3. Okay, log a equal to, so log a equal to log b means a equal to b. So x square minus 3x minus 5 equal to 7 minus 2. But one should be very careful after getting solutions and you put it back, you should make sure it is positive. I cannot say log minus 5 equal to log minus 5. Log minus 5 is not even defined. Okay. So later on, I need to check that they are positive. X square minus x minus 12 equal to 0. Yes, roots are there, yeah. X minus 4 into x plus 3 equal to 0. X is equal to 4 or minus 3. 4 is not okay, minus 3 is okay. Because when I put 4, 7 minus 2x will be negative. Okay, 7 minus 2x is less than 0, log is not different. Here, 7 minus 2x is positive and even x square minus 3x minus 5 is positive. That's why it is okay. So whenever we are cancelling log and we are solving some equations, so we should be careful that log a equal to log b doesn't mean just a and b are equal, they should be positive. Are you another sir is revising some previous topic or starting some fresh topic?
Revising, sir.
Revising.
All. Normally for you up to work power energy is over, huh?
Yes, sir.
Yes,
yes, sir.
Sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Even circular motion also started, no?
No, sir.
No, sir. No, sir.
Okay. Okay, now 15th question. 2 power log A 2 power 1 by 4. Minus 3 power log 27 a square plus 1 whole cube minus 2a by 7 power 4 log a base 49 minus a minus 1. They just want to simplify this, that's all, nothing else. They're asking you to simplify. Okay, so we need to use these two formulas mostly. K power log x base a is x, if these two are same. And a power log b base a is b power log a base a. This b and a can be interchanged. So these are the two formulas that we learned at the last. That. What I am going to do, I am going to bring this a here, this 2 here, based on the second formula. Here, I put second by 3 cube and take it out and then cancel this. This one, this is 49. So, first I have to take 4 here and then interchange this. Okay. So, here straight away I'm going to bring A here, 2 here. That is A power log 2 base 2 power 1 by 4. Interchanging this one. This one also I can do that. Just bring this one here, this one here. 3 4. A square plus 1 also. Log 3 base 27. 4 power log 3 base 27. 3 here and this A square plus 1. Minus 2A. This power 4 I'll give it here. 7 power log of a power 4 base 49. M log a, you can write log a power m. Minus a minus. Okay, so first I interchange these two. That is the formula I have done from here to here, this formula. Here also same, interchange this and this. Here just this 4, I made it power here. Okay. What is this? Whenever any power, you can take it out as reciprocal. Yeah. So I'm going to get here a power 1 by 1 by 4 into log 2 base 2. If any power here, it will come out in the numerator. Any power here, I have to write in the denominator. That's why 1 by 1 by 4. Minus a square plus 1 whole cube. Whole power log 3 base 27, I can write 3 minus 2a. By the denominator, I can bring a power 4 here, 7 here. A power 4 log 7 base 49. Minus a, minus b. I think actually I should have simplified this one separately, this separately, this separately. It's easy to write, but it's okay. Okay, so please see that mainly I'm using this formula. Okay, without changing the base of the log, I can interchange these two. Here a and 2, here a square plus 1 whole cube and 2. Here also a power 4, here 7. Okay, log 2 base 2 is 1, 1 by 1 by 4 is 4. So I'm getting a power 4. This one, a square plus 1 whole cube. This 3, I have to take it out in the power as denominator. It will be 1 by 3 log 3 base 3 minus 2. Here, a power 4, 49, I can write 7 square. Log 7 base 7 square. Minus a, minus a. I can directly write 1 by 2. I'm just writing like this. After all, 7 is root 49. 49 power 1 by 2. Okay, this is straight away a power 4. Log 3 base 3 is 1. When you multiply the power of this 3, this 3 will go directly. You'll get minus of a square plus 1 minus 2a. Here, actually, this 2 will come out as 1 by 2 and log 7 base will be 1. That will be a power 4 whole power 1 by 2 log 7 base 7 minus a minus. A power 4. If I take minus common, the numerator is a square plus 2a plus 1, which is a perfect square. And here, log 7 base 7 is 1. A power 4 whole power 1 by 2 a square minus 1 minus. This is a power 4 minus a plus 1 whole square by a square minus a minus 1. Even a power 4, I can write a square whole square. This is in the form of a square minus b square. I can write a plus b into a minus b. So the numerator is a square plus a plus 1 into a square minus a minus 1 by a square minus a minus 1. You cancel. So we left with a square plus a plus 1. Okay, mainly better you look each one separately. How this alone became a power 4, how this alone became a square plus 1, and how this alone became a square. That is the three parts I could have done separately. After that, simplification is a square minus b square formula, a plus b into a minus b. I'm ready to explain the whole question or any part of it. If somebody has doubt, so please feel free to ask doubt. And those are learning for the first time, don't be afraid of the expressions that you are writing. If you see carefully, you'll be able to follow. Otherwise, today you go through the small questions on each formula, which I'll send to you. By tomorrow, you'll be able to understand better. Anybody has gone through that PDF that I sent yesterday with solutions of preparatory course? Especially the new students who are learning for the first time.
Sir?
Yes, please.
Sir, in the 17th question, log of root of x squared to the base 10. So what restriction should we apply on x? Root of x square should be greater than 0? Or
yeah, that's it. The total root x square should be greater than 0. So basically x should not be 0. That's the only condition, because root x square is anyway positive.
Okay, sir. Means x should not be 0.
That is for RHS. What about LHS?
LHS, x should be less than 0.
Yes. There is something more later on. Why? Not only for log, square root is there, na?
Yes, sir. So I took the intersection.
Yeah. No, what is inside the root also can't be negative.
Log, yes, sir, minus. I got it as minus x greater than or equal to 1.
Okay.
And when I opened the log, minus x should be greater than 0. So x should be less than or equal to 1 or less than and less than 0. So x should be less than 0.
Lilla Krishna, understood this 15th one?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Anybody else who are learning logarithms for the first time, can you please respond?